A hawk flying overhead can easily catch your attention. It isn't at all uncommon to see predatory birds in the Lower Chippewa River Basin here in western Wisconsin. It is home to a number of living things, or organisms. Even the red-shouldered hawk can be found in the Lower Chippewa River Basin, although it is so rare in the state as a whole that it is on the Wisconsin DNR's list of species of greatest conservation need. The red-shouldered hawk is here because, among the many different habitats or places for organisms to live, here in the Lower Chippewa River Basin is mature floodplain forest. A mature forest is one that has been forest for a long time. Some of the trees are large and old, the canopy is closed in many places, and there is less undergrowth than in younger forests. A floodplain forest is a forest on low-lying land near a river or stream. These areas often flood, hence the name. Red-shouldered hawks live in mature floodplain forests. They belong to the group of hawks known as budios. Instead of circling, these hawks hunt by perching in trees or other high places until they see something moving and pounce on it. In mature floodplain forests, there's room between the trees to maneuver, and less undergrowth to slow the hawk down. Tiffany Bottom State Wildlife Area, 45 minutes south of Eau Claire, contains part of one of the largest continuous hardwood forests in the upper Midwest. It's on low land, making it prone to floods and a good habitat for red-shouldered hawks. In addition to its value as a home for wildlife, Tiffany Bottoms is used for recreation. People hike, canoe, hunt, and fish on the land. Large areas of forest like those in Tiffany Bottoms are just what red-shouldered hawks need. The hawks need a lot of space, although exactly how much seems to vary. The New York Audubon Society suggests at least 25 acres per bird, while a study in Georgia found that a breeding pair's average home range, the area they spent time in and protected, was 320 acres. Tiffany Bottom State Wildlife Area is 13,000 acres, although not all of that is forested. Red-shouldered hawks are less likely to live in small areas of forest. Forest that's broken by roads, fields, or other habitats is fragmented. Not only does this reduce the overall area of forest available, but even the remaining fragmented areas of forest aren't as good habitat for red-shouldered hawks as the unfragmented habitat was. The edges of forests often have more open canopies and more undergrowth than the interior. Several fragmented areas of forest will have more edge than a single unfragmented forested area, even if the total forested acreage is the same. In these more open edges, red-shouldered hawks are driven away by larger red-tailed hawks, which harass, attack, and sometimes even kill them. Sometimes people confuse red-shouldered and red-tailed hawks. Red-shouldered hawks have longer, narrower wings with pale crescents. Their undersides are striped white and red. They are also smaller than red-tailed hawks and have a distinctive call. Red-shouldered hawks are worth protecting because of their top predator status. Animals that eat other animals but are not eaten themselves are top predators. Scientists sometimes use top predators to indicate the overall health of a group of organisms and the place where they live, or an ecosystem. If the numbers of an organism the top predator eats are dropping, the top predator's numbers will also drop. If the food source of one of the organisms that is eaten becomes less common, so will the organism that eats it, and eventually the top predator will too. Red-shouldered hawks show that the floodplain forests of the Lower Chippewa River Basin are reasonably healthy. It would be nice to keep them that way. The DNR manages the floodplain forest of Tiffany Bottoms through selective logging, which allows foresters to make a profit while maintaining the habitat. The same strategy can be used on private land. Red-shouldered hawks are especially sensitive during the nesting season, which runs from March through the summer. Logging and the use of heavy machinery near suspected nesting sites should be avoided during this time. This gives red-shouldered hawks a chance to breed and raise their young. Take advantage of Tiffany Bottoms to appreciate this unique habitat. If you see a red-shouldered hawk, no matter where in Wisconsin, report it to the website on the screen. Scientists are trying to get a better idea of where they can be found and how many there are. To learn more, contact the DNR or a Raptor Rehabilitation Center.